So the next step is to perform some classification, and there's some click and point tools that make this process extremely easy. So first of all, we can start with the big building elements. And what you want to do is follow the instructions in the pink highlighted bar down the bottom to select in a number of different ways. So by holding Control, you access a crosshair and single selection or rectangle select mode. So again, holding Control and single selecting, this is how you select on an individual surface, for example, these ceilings. What you can then do is you can then move to the correct layer within the structure that we set up earlier. Once there's a pink highlight over the layer, the Classify button becomes available. What you can then do is click that Classify button, and that surface has changed colour to the purple to represent that that's moved into the ceiling layer. Once you've classified into a layer, a greener highlight will indicate that there's data in here. It's often a good idea to keep layers switched off as you're classifying into them so that you're continually removing them from view. I can do the same for the floor here. Again, just in two clicks, classified the floor, choose to classify, and again, switch that layer off. To deselect using the single select, repeat the process, but hold shift instead of control. Before using the rectangle select tool, it's a good idea to double click on the object that you're interested in. Double clicking will bring that object to the center of the view and make it the center of zooming in, zooming out, and rotating, making it much easier to classify. From here, I can again hold Control, but instead of single selecting, which is going to take a lot of time for these complicated structures, what you can instead do is hold Control still, click and drag, and use a selection box. From here, again, you can find the correct layer, in this case a lighting fixture, and you can either choose to classify or merge that feature into that layer. To deselect using the rectangle select, repeat the process, except this time hold Shift instead of Control. The alternative way of classifying is to use the polygon select, and you can change the mode up in the top left hand corner of the screen. By changing to polygon select, selection still is driven by control, but what you now do is click once to begin drawing a box, which can be any shape you want. You confirm the selection by releasing control. Once it's selected, it's the same as any other classification tool, you can just choose to classify. To deselect using the polygon select, repeat the same process, but holding Shift instead of Control. Releasing Shift to activate the deselection. As an additional tip, Polygon Select stays on, so to revert back to a single click or rectangle selection, you want to just reselect the option in the top left-hand corner. One of the most useful keyboard shortcuts to try to remember to use as you're classifying is the Alt and G keyboard shortcut. So that's the Alt key and the G key. So two separate keys. What this keyboard shortcut does is it will hide any unselected surfaces. So if I just do a quick selection of this light fixture, the way this tool works is when activated, it will switch off all of the unselected surfaces and just leave the pink highlighted surfaces in view. So if I right click and choose only show selected geometries, as you can see, it's a really quick way of identifying if any surfaces have been accidentally selected below the object of interest. So what you can then do is then very quickly hold Shift to do a remove select box, find its layer, and choose to classify. So one more time, and this is really the quickest way to classify, is to make sure that you're remembering those keyboard shortcuts. So Control Select, Alt G, or it's in the right click menu as only show selected geometries. Just flip that view angle 90 degrees, then hold Shift, click and drag, and remove those surfaces. So Control, Group Select, Alt and G, flip, remove, classify.